this afternoon. Plenty of sunshine. High 81. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 71, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook. America, don't you cry. Lift me up, give me strength to press on.
Make one mistake and I'm dead.
That'll certainly wake you up in the morning. All this hail slammed the Denver area. What's going to happen over Memorial Day weekend is what we're really talking about today. Hey, thanks for flipping over to the Weather Channel Live. Flipping over, huh? You've been with us for a while. We appreciate it.
Well, hey. I like to think they're TiVoing it if they're not home.
Can I say hi to Mrs. Sitkowski's class at Vero Beach Elementary School?
Hey, guys.
No, they said no, we can't do that.
Oh.
Okay, sorry.
We just did. I'm Alex Holzen here with Dave Schwartz. We just got to talk to them during our break, but we've got some other things to tell everyone about. Hail, not just a problem in Colorado 2 days before the holiday weekend. Look at this new picture into the Weather Channel. This was from last evening's storms.
Ouch.
Bringing some major hailstones.
Oh.
This is from Monticello, Iowa. Holes actually just punched right into the back windshield of the car.
That windshield looks like it's made of, like, saran wrap or something. Like they went right through it.
Hail the size of golf balls. Reports of hail covering the ground up to 3 inches deep. And that guy... it's calling State Farm or Nationwide or somebody today. Sorry, Kevin.
The threat of severe weather is further east, at least for the time being. Let's get right to it. Here's Carl Parker, our severe storms guy. Carl?
Hey, Dave, things are starting to go now across the central part of the Ohio Valley, and let's take a look at the latest warning that is in effect north of Indianapolis. This is a severe thunderstorm warning. There was a tornado warning on this cell. It has expired. A little bit of rotation being seen in the cell, but we got no confirmation on whether or not there was, in fact, a tornado there. Here's the latest on that warning, and again, that is northwest of Indianapolis, so a severe thunderstorm warning now in effect for Boone and Clinton counties. The movement is southeast of about 30 or 35 miles per hour. We did get a report of 1-inch hail here in Frankfort, and there's a look at the hail tracker. It's going to take that hail just south of Kirkland down past Route 421 and across Route 47 as well, and maybe just south of Sheridan. So in general, what we've got is a warm and humid air mass across the Ohio Valley and also over towards the Mid-Atlantic region, and the Storm Prediction Center now looking at a very high probability of a severe thunderstorm watch there in Maryland, Northern Virginia, and the D.C. metro area. And in general, what we've got here is a wind threat for the most part in the Mid-Atlantic region and a wind and large hail threat in the Ohio Valley. And we will see more very strong storms tomorrow along the East Coast and back and into parts of Kentucky and Tennessee. Now back through the high plains, an entirely different situation here. Got winds coming out of the southeast at the surface, but notice the clouds there off to the west. So you've got a mid-level flow that's coming out of the southwest. And because of that turning of the wind with height, we are likely to see supercell storms and tornadoes. And now the Storm Prediction Center looking at a tornado watch. They're likely to issue a tornado watch in southeastern Wyoming and eastern parts of Colorado. And here's the model forecast showing supercell breaking out there in Colorado later this afternoon. Very well could produce a tornado or two, and then we find up more activity into late this evening. Certainly a hail and wind threat. Even storms lining up along I-70 there in Kansas. So all threats here in these areas in the Central Plains, Dave, talking about tornadoes, possibly wind and hail as well through later today. Over to you.
And a very active day. Thanks a lot, Carl. You know, there's one place in the country where they'll say, fine, we got a holiday weekend, rains in the forecast, no problem. It's here in West Texas and Western Oklahoma where the drought is just exceptional. Well, right now, look at the dew point temperatures. There's almost as much moisture in the air in Lubbock as there is in Houston, right near the Gulf of Mexico. That is lovely. And with that storm that's over California getting closer and closer to us, we're expecting some much needed rain. Lubbock, Texas, total annual rainfall 2014, less than 1 inch. Not that we get a lot of rain to begin with, but that is really, that's one of the driest starts to a year we've ever had. So this, perfect. There might be some hail thrown in there. We can handle it. Huh? We'll get into our storm shelters. It's the rain. You don't get this kind of day after day rain in this part of the country this time of year. So this is perfect. With more on this drought in the Southern Plains, here's Alex Wilson.
Yeah, Dave, because these areas that you just showed are desperately in need of some of that rainfall. Take a look, 27% of the South under at least extreme drought. The worst conditions, the exceptional drought up in the panhandle of Texas and Oklahoma. Some areas that you just mentioned are going to see some of that persistent days of rainfall. Well, time now to continue our Cracked series, looking at the ongoing drought plaguing much of the country. Today, we take you to Mendota, California. It sits in fertile, fresh country, which leads the country in agriculture. It normally produces up to 70% of our cantaloupes, but now it's ground zero for a devastating drought that's bringing a community that depends on agriculture to its knees.
It's called the Cantaloupe Center of the World, but as the water continues to disappear, so too do the melons.
You know, we got the richest agricultural area in California, and you see these brown spots because of lack of water. It's sad.
And as the cantaloupes vanish, a large percentage of jobs in this town of 11,000 do as well.
We're roughly about 40% unemployment. It's higher than normal. Right now, because of the water situation and the farmers are not planting, it's an indication that it's going to be close to maybe 55% by the time the situation is over.
And with more people out of work, that means less money to spend, which creates a ripple effect to business owners like Rolando Castro, who owns an auto repair shop.
I'm holding up because I get out-of-town work. That's how I've been holding up. You know, unfortunately, I had to advertise out-of-town because this town, it's looking like a ghost town.
It's so bad that downtown streets are periodically turned into food lines.
It's ugly to see the people standing in line, because they're out of a job. And the main thing is they're being provided, and there's a lot of agencies realize that people have to eat. It's really something that out of like a third world country right here in Central California where people have to stand in line to get food to put on the table.
In February, President Obama visited the drought-plagued area and pledged financial assistance, but without water, everyone will pay the long-term price.
Funny thing is that back east, everybody's drowning. Colorado's got all the snow, and California's burning up. Wait until they start seeing that the peaches and the nectarines and tomatoes and lettuce and corn that is being produced here in the state of California, when they start paying the high prices, then they're gonna say, what happened?
Political water wars are occurring all over the state of California. You got the endangered species, which a lot of folks think that it's more important to keep the water up north instead of send it down south and putting people back to work. This area is so rich in ag that when you cut off that water to the farmers, it affects a lot of people. So it's not just Mendota, but it's going to be a disaster for a lot of cities here in the Central Valley.
And it's not just the farm workers suffering from this drought. With less money coming in, less money goes out to businesses, restaurants, and even schools. Tomorrow, we'll take you to America's most endangered river and show you why this water crisis could become a catastrophe.
All right, but first, we've got a severe weather threat that's expanding. A severe thunderstorm watch at the Ohio Valley and now a tornado watch along the Front Range of the Rockies, including Cheyenne, Wyoming, Denver, Fort Collins, Colorado. Tornado watch is in effect now until 8 o'clock Mountain Time. That's I-25 and I-70. We'll have more on the threat of severe weather here and north of Indianapolis. That's coming up as Weather Center Live continues.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. this afternoon. Plenty of sunshine. High 81. Winds east northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 71, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Average blames the camera for those extra 10 pounds. Beat average with GNC.
Surely a vacuum shouldn't just work on carpets. Well, the Dyson DC65 cleans better than any other vacuum across hard floors and carpets. Works for me.